So,
we're ready.
Have we got someone to put on a little speaker, maybe? Yes.
Are we
ready for another little celebrity to come on the stage? Yay! They've had enough of us.
We're yesterday.
We're done.
We're the official Chip newspaper now.
Oh.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Michael, who are you bringing on now?
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the amazing Anthony Cotton!
I've had the most amazing day here, and I've never been more proud to represent my hometown of Manchester wearing this t-shirt in our capital city. Listen, in the early hours of yesterday morning, the LGBT community lost one of our greatest allies, the EU. And we have to remember that the EU has supported us and looked after us and campaigned for us, and it gave us our equal rights, and it gave us the chance, the luck, not to be discriminated against because of our sexual orientation. And it gave us not to be discriminated against in the workplace. And when we travel to see our friends and family in Spain or France, it means that we travel with the same respect and the same equalities that we do in our own country. The fight is not over. We have to remember that those liberties that were given to us by the EU may be taken away. So we have to fight to keep those liberties. We have to. Next Tuesday, we'll see the 47th anniversary of the Stonewall riots. And 47 years ago, it was the camp, the femme, the sissies, the trans, the drag acts, the butch dykes. They burned those streets in downtown Manhattan to give us this opportunity that so many countries to this day still don't give their LGBT communities. So it is absolutely our given that we have to support our LGBT brothers and sisters and those in between, our support and our love. And only a couple of weeks ago, there was a horrendous terrorist attack on the LGBT community in Orlando. And we have to remember that this shit is still going on. That said, we still live in a beautiful place. England, Great Britain, is a magnificent place to live, because look at this! I'd like to introduce you to a friend of mine. He's a friend of yours, and only a year ago, he wasn't who he is today. Would you like a bit of a 6'5" rugby player?
Yeah!
He's the world's only out and proud rugby league player. He's my best friend. Give a massive London Pride welcome to Keegan Hurst! So this is your first London Pride.
This is my first London Pride. Thank you for having me.
You enjoyed it?
I've had a great time. Everyone's been brilliant. Everyone's come out to see us. I've been on parade today. We've had a ball. We've had a ball. We're having a ball. And when I was at the parade, what I saw lots of lots of us guys, lots of the LGBT community, and lots of young families, you know, little kids. I've got little kids, and that's why I thought all this is about education. It's about teaching our kids what we're about. It's all right to be who you are. But it's not just about the kids, it's about our job to teach our work colleagues, our friends, our family, what's all right, what's okay. And we've got to be really proactive and educate everybody about what we're about.
Would you like a bit of a dance? Yeah. To perhaps your favourite Britain's Got Talent judge? She's a little pop starlet. Her plane was delayed. She's flown in especially for you lot from Paris. She was on a patisserie course, I think. She was making croissants. She's my particular favourite Britain's Got Talent judge. Her album, Do It For Love, is out on iTunes. You can buy it now. Please give a massive... Are we ready? Can we have a thumbs up? We've got a thumbs up. Please give a massive London Pride welcome to Alicia Dixon!